Now that you have learned about the different mechanisms through which music can cause an emotion, we will look at the bigger picture of analyzing music to find a source of pleasure. This diagram illustrates seven different dimensions of music that each can, independently of the others, cause us to experience a dopamine reward. Imagine that you enter a cafe where music is playing. There are a lot of sound sources causing waves in your inner ears. Conversations, cutlery, footsteps, and music. Each of these sound sources is separated and identified automatically in a process called auditory scene analysis. Now, this happens very rapidly because, of course, the brain's important job is to scan a new environment and be aware of sounds that might signal danger. Well, there aren't any dangerous sound sources in this delightful cafe, so you're free to push whichever sound source interests you into the foreground stream of your attention. Let's say you are curious about the music. So the first thing that happens is that your brain notices the timbres. Here we have guitar, vocal, and saxophone. That gives you a strong clue as to what style of music you are hearing. If you don't like jazz or other acoustic music, you might decide that you dislike it and you'll move on. This happens in under 3 seconds. However, if past experiences has shown you that you like this sort of music, you begin mentally scanning its features, predicting how the song might unfold in hopes of hearing something you like. Rhythm is the easiest. The tempo and metric organization is quickly analyzed. Do you like this bossa nova groove, and are they playing it well? If so, you have a little bit of dopamine release. Maybe the groove isn't your favorite, so you move over and scan the melody to see if you know this song. Or maybe if it's a novel tune, is it a sweet melody? After a while, you may move your spotlight of attention to the lyrics, listening for the kind of lyric that would offer you a treat. Perhaps you know this song. Let's say it's the classic Brazilian tune, The Girl from Ipanema. You like this song and have just now awakened a pleasant memory of the original recording. Do you approve of this version? Your attention will mentally assess the aesthetic dimensions. It's listening and analyzing, looking for a treat. You might find a treat in the novelty of the arrangement, or appreciate that they're using traditional real instruments and not, let's say, an electronic loop from a laptop. As always, there are the performance elements. Is this an authentic performance with genuine feel for this Jobim classic? Or does it sound as if the musicians are merely going through the motions? Each of us has a sweet spot on each of these dimensions. If any single one of these elements impresses or delights you, your brain will release some dopamine and you will enjoy this performance. On the other hand, if you search for and find no treats there, presuming that you were paying attention to the music and were actually listening for them, you will dismiss this music and focus on something else. Let's summarize music and emotion with a schematic of what's involved. As we listen to music, our response is under the influence of the external world and the internal world. How we feel on the inside determines how we behave on the outside, and vice versa. Music analysis happens in the overlap of these two worlds, and the music makers have no control over these. Therefore, music and emotion is under the influence of our peers, the setting where we encounter the music, and the occasion, which might be somber or celebratory, ordinary or extraordinary. Music and emotion is also affected by our mood, how motivated we are to pay attention, and what we know about what it is we are hearing. In the zone where these overlap, music is then analyzed, judged, and ultimately becomes the source of pleasure or annoyance. As the external and internal worlds change, so does this mechanism of intervening between music and emotion. So, returning to the previous scenario in the cafe, imagine how the music would feel if you were the only one in the audience. What if you and your date had a major argument and broke up at the table? Context matters to the emotions that we receive from music listening. Now, in the next video, we will look at the listener profile, and I'll give you a tool for understanding why the music you love best speaks to you the loudest.